so many people relegate their thoughts to, it's not important, nobody understands, or even worse, nobody cares anyways. But the reality is that it's relative. No worry is too small. Worries are like seeds. If that seed is planted and you leave it alone, it can grow into a mighty oak tree. Now ask yourself, what's easier? Taking a bad seed from the ground or cutting down a massive oak tree? Next time you think, I'll just forget about it, it's nothing, think about that analogy. Sometimes you just can't avoid the conflict. I think conflict avoidance is one of the biggest detriments to happiness and has been the biggest factor in my own life for dealing with chronic worry. I know that time and again, I figuratively built mountains out of molehills by avoiding a conversation or situation that I built up in my own head. I avoided the conversation or the situation because I wanted to avoid the feeling of unease that I knew would inevitably come from it. I would regularly avoid my inner conflict because of some story I told myself to justify the situation. Oh, I don't want to hurt this person's feelings, or it's probably not true anyways, etc. There were times when I just didn't want to admit that I was too much of a coward to take ownership of a situation. Now, I like to think of tough words as workouts. All the growth and results come from leaning into the pain of the workout. If you are too comfortable when you work out, your body never really changes. You need to go outside of your comfort zone. Vincent van Gogh said, "The comfort zone is a beautiful place, but nothing ever grows there." In the gym, your body responds by losing more body fat or building more muscle. But when you deal with worry, your mind responds by making you happier. If you are worried about something right now and it keeps coming up again and again, what conversation or situation are you avoiding? That's probably the one you need to have in order to rid yourself of chronic worry. Chapter 11. Practical Life Tips.